Ah!
Jackdaw's flown, Edward. Eh? That's the beauty of a democracy. The many outvote the one. Oh, you could sail with me, but with a temper as hot as yours, I fear you'd burn us all to cinders. Luckily, I know the king's bounty on your head is a large one, and I intend to collect. Have you ever seen the inside of a Jamaican prison, boy?
That'll pass. It's the midazolam. I'm sorry about this, but we've had so many security breaches, we were forced to take drastic action. And Buddy Vie is missing. He left for Chicago 2 days ago, but no one's seen him since. I know this seems excessive, but with our high-level security clearance, we have an obligation to our shareholders. Rest assured, we will compensate you when the hacker is found. So get some rest, okay? And if you're up to it, maybe capture some more footage? You're doing amazing work. I can't wait to show you the work we've been doing with your stuff. Take care.
So, they tossed you in the bunker. Nice. Those Templars upstairs aren't taking any chances. I think we need to erase all the dirt they might have on you. Did you hear that? I think I just gave you level 3 security clearance. Now, head to the security room and use the cameras to watch the door to the server farm. Unfortunately, Melanie's in there now. So when I escort her out, that's when you make your move. I'd wipe these servers myself, but as the head of IT, I'd be a suspect. It has to be someone they've already locked up. These Templars. They run our lives, you know. They decide elections, they control various capital markets, and they inject us with little micro... Hey, you know you're supposed to be locked up, right? Going back upstairs ain't a good plan. All right, listen, I'm entering the server room now. When you see us leave, get in there.
Okay.
All right. I ditched her at the coffee stand. Find a server containing a network log. Since I have a record of each and every one of your hacks, we'll just search for the timestamps on those and turn that data into something harmless. Easy as that. Here we are. Beautiful. I'll update your communicator one more time. A little program I cooked up just for this purpose. There we go. I think that worked. Try it out.
Well, it's still too weak, and I am spread thin. Unfocused. Like static in fog. Lingering in networks and nodes. The nervous system of the world. Perhaps the temple was opened too soon, but this was not by choice. The cataclysm pushed all doubt aside. We bless poor Desmond, who gave his life so that you, the children of our labors, would live on, to fulfill your purpose in ours, in mine. But now is not the time. My strength is not sufficient to inhabit an organic vessel. There is more work to do, more samples to acquire, more artifacts to find before my will can obtain.
What's happening? Tell me!
Make me whole again, my children, my instruments. Bring me forth to fulfill your purpose.
His Majesty's Court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway. Born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother. Married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastards, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead.
What's your name? Billock? Kenmore? Conway?
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Then that's the rumor going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, gotta make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. I'm back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
Oi! Stop that!
Hey!
Quiet, you!
Oi!
Quiet, you!
say?
Oi!
Open this gibbet.
Stop that!
Stop!
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Just have to pull the trigger. You're not losing us. Faster.
Raise
the alarm!
Maybe he has friends looking out for him.
You! Stop there!
Shit! Alarm! Alarm!
Bloody hot lads! He's trying to play it!
You're not losing this! Faster!
He
sight.
In my sight.
Clear shot on it.
I've got a clear shot, man.
Keep him hemmed in.
Leading trap, or I'll flip the other way.
Mary. Mary, it's me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child.
They took her. No idea where.
I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent.
Can you walk?
Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
I can't.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
Stop. Stop, please.
I ain't leaving you, damn it. Lift your arm.
It's no good.
Should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Who are you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
I'll be with you, can we? To Mary. A trunk.
Is she gone?
I know. Oh, gosh! Oh!
What will you do now?
Nothing sensible.
You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward Kenway.
See some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in one-fifth the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. Short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll swithe in you, maggot. I'll cut you down! Calm, little puppy, and slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness. Robert!
Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Raise a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Down on powerful wings to seize a grazing lamb and carry it off to her nest. Flying close by, a jackdaw saw the deed, and it filled his head with the idea that he too was just as strong and capable. So, with a great flapping and rustling of feathers, the jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the colt of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal, for he tried and even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram hardly noticed. Nearby, just across the field, the shepherd saw the fluttering bird and was quite amused. Running up, he captured it.
No more than 2 years! You promised me!
You left! When I needed you the most!
But you had me! What keeps you wondering? Do I not make you happy?
I'm so close, Caroline! Please! Just let me do this!
Is everything you do out of spite, Edward?
It's not spite that's driving me, Mary! It's courage!
Courage for what, man? There's no one left in your life to care!
God damn you all! I can handle this!
Lout! Always tearing down when you could be building things up, or building yourself up if nothing else!
Just leave me be!
Change course, Edward! Change your bloody course before it's too late!
Captain Kenway! You look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
Put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I shall have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
So we set sail. You're leaving?
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.
Thank you.
Jesus, Addy, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
I'm not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable course. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain Kenway.
Mary. Before she died, she asked me to do good by her. To sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye. She told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why, indeed.
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom. Not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edward I met here many years ago. So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Stay close. Follow my lead.
Good to see you here, brother!
¡Vamos a batirlo de un tiro!
Most of what killed our old editor.
Finish him off!
That coward is hiding aboard his ship.
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Edward.
I'm sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd not be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing, drinking, fighting.
You are a fighter, I. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
It's all true. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his Lathram passed out in the hold from drink. Everyone's gone, aren't they? Mary, Bracken, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so. Rough as they were. Do you fear that too? All empty inside?
I do. The devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough, but how will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers. Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. Might take months to find him.
4 years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, don't be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster! What's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bond. Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads! We're sailing for Jamaica!
How does it feel to bark so loud?
I've barked louder, and to men twice as rough.
Tending bar at the old aviary, you mean?
Among other places. And I sailed with Mary in Rackham for a time, remember?
Of course.
Mary did most of the captaining, Jack did most of the drinking.
Did she ever tell you who it was that fathered her child?
It was a young fellow. Sailed with us on that last voyage. Poor lad was killed fighting beside us. The only man not too drunk to stand up for himself.
There was so much about her I didn't know. I called her a friend. But was I one in return?
She thought the world of you, Edward. I've no worries about that.
Well, that's good to hear.
Soon we'll be warping her out through the locks. Way, roll and go. Where the pretty young girls all come down in their frocks. Be rollicking, randy dandy, oh. Heave a port, oh, heave away. Waves on board and the cables all scored. Be rollicking.